LEGO Mindstorms is coming to an end. LEGO is discontinuing Mindstorms. Yes, LEGO Mindstorms was one of the most iconic LEGO themes, but now it's coming to an end. LEGO Mindstorms Robot Inventor is retiring in 2023 and there is no known replacement of it. Released in 2020, Robot Inventor was one of the most controversial Mindstorm sets, with many fans saying it was inferior to its predecessor. The software support is expected to come to an end by 2024, at least for Mindstorms, since LEGO is keeping their educational line that has some of the same hardware but uses a different software. The Spike Prime series is not affected, thus the functionality of the Robot Inventor is to be integrated into the Spike app. How comprehensive this integration will be is yet to be seen. It is already possible to use the Robot Inventor after a firmware update with the Spike app. But how did we get here? Let's take a look at the history of LEGO Mindstorms. Before the idea of LEGO robots came to be, we had the turtle robots. These were educational toys that taught kids how to program. However, they had a small limitation, that being their shapes. So, a group of people at a company called Micro World decided to use LEGO to make their robotics teaching endeavor. LEGO was playing with the idea of an education theme. We already had Dacta. These products had a focus on education and teaching kids many subjects. LEGO also tapped onto the programming subject, so they joined forces with the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. They would begin the long process of creating a programming educational LEGO theme. We had many prototypes, like the red brick. This would combine the powers of LEGO and computers. It was tested in 3 schools, but improvements were made. LEGO would involve and create the RCX. In 1998, LEGO Mindstorms would premiere. This theme was in the making for a long time, but when it was released, it was a super success, with even a robotics competition being created, something that became associated with this theme, and also the first LEGO League, a partnership between LEGO and FIRST. Unfortunately, the worst part were the commercials.
With LEGO Mindstorms and your computer, you can build and program robots that do what you want, like capture special family moments. Forever. Introducing LEGO Mindstorms, your imagination rules.
I mean, who approved this? Besides this, the RCX used RCX code, or RoboLab, which was based on LabVIEW as its main programming language. Sets included were the Dark Side Developer Kit,
the Ultimate Builder Set,
and the Droid Developer Kit with a Star Wars license.
We would like to play.
In 2006, we'd see a new version of the motors, the NXT. This featured a new design and contained servo motors, and with its sensors it had light, sound and distance, and also one for touch. It came in these sets, the Mindstorms NXT. In 2009, LEGO would introduce a 2.0 version of this set. They added another touch center. This time the brick had a 48 MHz processor with 64 kilobytes of RAM memory. In 2014, we would have the EV3 intelligent brick. This was a major leap in the world of LEGO robotics. It even could run Linux on it. This time with 64 megabytes of RAM. It also included USB and microSD slots and supported both Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connections, and included were 2 large motors, 1 medium motor, 2 touch screens, 1 color sensor, gyroscopic sensor and 1 ultrasonic sensor. The EV3 was popular, but over time its popularity started to wane down. By now, LEGO Mindstorms had existed for almost 20 years, and it was having many problems attracting newer audiences. In fact, most Mindstorm fans were adults or students. At this time, this didn't seem like a major problem, but its consequences would be catastrophic. However, LEGO seemed to try and solve this with other sets that were focused towards kids. LEGO introduced LEGO Boost, which was a more simplified version of Mindstorms, not focused on the cool things you can do, like clicking that subscribe button right now. And if you are a LEGO Mindstorms expert, I challenge you to create a robot that can click the subscribe button of this channel and send it to me on Instagram. Thanks. But LEGO Boost also focused on the wow factor.
Wow.
The main set was released in 2017, the Boost Creative Toolbox. We would also get an R2-D2 one. However, one missed opportunity was to make a LEGO Friends one with this set that didn't include robotics, but they could have made this Zobo a robot, right? Another missed opportunity for LEGO was a mid-cycle refresh of Mindstorms, like a mid-generation update. This would also be a reason for Mindstorms' downfall, as many probably lost interest in the theme. In 2020, LEGO Mindstorms would enter a pretty divisive and controversial chapter in its history. The new set, Robot Inventor, actually got rid of many of the EV3's features, like being able to run many EV3's side by side at the same time. But there were some improvements, like the force sensor, absolute positioning motors, and finally compatibility with powered up. Unfortunately, the hardcore stuff, like the lack of daisy chaining, made fans angry and reluctant to switch to the new system. And fans still think the system is targeted at the younger audiences. After 2020, things did not look good for Mindstorms. In fact, a fellow YouTuber called UnbreakMe predicted that the thing would be retiring really soon. In his video, he cites,
"As a result, it's completely possible that Mindstorms may not sell well. I personally love the new 51515 set, and I believe it's a great addition to the LEGO Powered Up line. However, LEGO Technic Motorization and LEGO Robotics have always been two different spheres. And since the new system does lack daisy chaining and expandable storage, it does cause a lack of interest in the Mindstorms community."
Now, imagine if M&R Productions released a video called LEGO Star Wars is ending. Everybody would freak out and riot on the streets. But for Mindstorms, that did not quite happen. The theme was already down, and all that LEGO needed to do was remove the plug from the outlet. At this point, LEGO Mindstorms, from LEGO's point of view, was not at its best, so it financially made sense for LEGO to end the theme. However, ending the Mindstorms brand was not the best idea, as the brand has recognition, and many like myself know it. At this point, it was clear that Mindstorms was not attracting new fans, and with the chip shortage and with the supply chains, and let's not forget inflation, LEGO Mindstorms had its final nail in the coffin. Let's go back to the news. By the end of 2022, LEGO Mindstorms and some other products will be retiring. The development team will be redirected to other products, such as the LEGO Education Online. It does feature some similarities to LEGO Mindstorms, and it will still be available for schools, as education is one of the more humanitarian issues of LEGO, rather than being just a profit thing. And sets like Spike Essential and Powered Up will still go on. As of when this video is being uploaded, the app is still available and I downloaded it. However, support will end in 2024, but you can still use PyBricks code. So, what is the future of LEGO Mindstorms? Well, I do unfortunately have to say it's not a bright one. I can see the same thing that happened to Bionicle happen with this, with many LEGO Mindstorms fans just leaving the LEGO hobby altogether, but there is a small chance that LEGO Mindstorms is just taking a short nap and will make a return soon. But what do you think? If you want to see the rise and fall of LEGO Mindstorms, click this video on the screen right now.